Hello again and welcome. Thank you for joining me. I'm Dave, KG0ZZ, and I am back with another antenna project. In this video, I'm going to try my hand at building a 75 meter double bazooka antenna. And I'm using 3.9 megahertz for my calculations, so this is for the upper portion of the 80 meter band, or what we call 75 meter phone. And before getting started, I checked the internet for some plans, and I even came across a couple of formulas, and I'll share those with you in a few moments. I also checked my old ARRL antenna handbook for some information too before getting started. It starts off with a couple of paragraphs and a basic design of the antenna, and what it says that a double bazooka antenna is a dipole antenna with 2 1/4 wave coaxial resonator stubs. Now, I know the feed point's a little bit different, but it calls it a dipole, and that's because it's equal on both sides. But the book goes on to say that the double bazooka antenna has about 1.14 times as much, or about 14% more bandwidth than that of a regular dipole. And so with the wider bandwidth, we get the name bazooka. The book shows it like a flat top dipole antenna. And they also show the use of a balun. On the internet, on the plans that I found for the antenna, no one was using a balun, and there is absolutely no mention of an RF choke. And so what they're doing is they're just feeding the antenna directly with coaxial cable. One interesting note, the antenna, the double bazooka antenna, at least one section of the antenna is made out of coaxial cable, and that's the part that you feed your feed line to. And so one important note that I saw in some of the plans that I saw was that you should leave the leads to the antenna a little bit long, as much as about 4 inches, if you're not using an SO239 connector and you're feeding your coaxial cable directly to the antenna. It said to leave the leads long, and that would help to prevent any interaction between the coaxial cable and the antenna. And so I thought that was an interesting point. But there are lots of different ways of building the double bazooka antenna. In the book, it goes on into different matching networks, different LC matching networks that you can try using. It also shows crossing the connection in the center and creating a cross double bazooka. And so there's been a lot of different ideas that have been tried with this this antenna that has the increased bandwidth. I'm going to feed the antenna direct with coaxial cable. I'm going to use an SO239 connector, and I'm going to put the antenna up in an inverted V shape and put that up on the side of my tower. Really, there are a lot of different ways of building the antenna. You can build a double bazooka antenna either all out of, you can make the entire antenna out of coaxial cable, or you can use a combination of coaxial cable and some 300 ohm twin lead. Or if you just still don't have if you don't have that, you could use a combination of coaxial cable and some wire. And so there are some different things that you can use. And a lot of guys will ask me if they can use different material or different cable or something. And usually a lot of times I think it'll work. But the answer is usually try it and experiment with it. I have not used this foam insulated 300 ohm twin lead, and so that's going to be an experiment. I've only used the other kind with the without the foam. I don't have, this is LMR 400, and I don't have enough of it to build this antenna out of. And if you make the antenna out of this, this is going to be one big heavy antenna. This is 100 foot of RG8X, and I've got 100 feet of RG58. The 8X here has a stranded center, but the RG58 that I'm using has a solid center. The solid center, that's only a piece of 20 gauge wire, and that will break very easily if you just solder to it and you're trying to use that for a connection. What the book recommends that we use is the RG58U with a stranded center. And it's a lot smaller, a lot lighter, and it just makes more sense to use something that small. But again, you may be concerned about strength, or, you know, I know some guys are trying to optimize their antenna by making it just as fat as possible, and so a lot of guys will build it out of RG8. So what I'm limited to here is the 8X, and so this is what I'm going to have to use. And 100 feet is not going to be enough to make it all out of coaxial cable. Now I could use the 300 ohm twin lead and put on the ends of it and make the double bazooka that way, but I'm going to use this 14 gauge wire instead. This is a 14 gauge stranded wire, and I'm going to put that on the ends. I'm going to make my antenna longer so that I can adjust the ends of it. After I play with it with some wire as tail sections, then I can go, you know, I can take the antenna down, get a measurement off of the tail sections, and I can make, you know, another tail section using something else, but I'd have the length that I want to use, and, you know, after adjusting the wire, and so then I'd be able to cut my cable and it would all be adjusted. If you're going to make it out of the 300 ohm twin lead, or with coax, you may have to make your antenna a little bit long in order to do some tuning. You're also going to have to figure out how to support that, or, you know, your cable to tie it off to an insulator. So you need a little bit of extra wire just to tie it off to insulators, or clamp it onto a piece of plexiglass or something like that, piece of acrylic plastic. If you only have the RG58 with this solid center, you could try cutting some strips of acrylic plastic and use some small U-bolts. These are wire rope clips, and I'm going to use some of these here too with this project. And I'm going to take the saddle off, but you could use that and clamp the two ends of the two sections together just to give it some strength so that it's not pulling on that lightweight 20 gauge wire. So, and here's a simple diagram of a double bazooka. The center section here from here to here is one length of coaxial cable, and in the center to feed the antenna, you carefully strip away just a section of the outer jacket on this piece of coaxial cable in the center, and then very carefully cut that shielded braid on the coaxial cable and separate that into two leads. And then these become our feed point for the antenna. On the ends of the coaxial cable sections, the braided shield is soldered to the center of the coaxial cable, and then a tail section is made and soldered onto the end of that. The tail section again could be a solid piece of wire, or it could be a piece of twin lead, or it could be a piece of coaxial cable. And so if you're using twin lead or coaxial cable, you'll solder the two ends together, the shield and the center, or the two leads on the twin lead. You'll solder the ends of them together on the tail piece, and you'll solder that to the end of the coaxial cable section. And so that's the only difference that I don't have written down here. The total length of the antenna, here comes the formulas. The total length of the antenna, they're using the formulas I found, 460 divided by the frequency in megahertz for the length in feet. So whatever band you want to build this for, this is the formula for the total length of the antenna. So 460 divided by 3.9 comes up to 117.949 feet rounded off. And then round it off again into fractions, 117 feet, 11 and 3/8 of an inch. Now, if I add just 5/8 of an inch, that'll make it a nice even 118 feet long. And that 5/8 of an inch or 5/16 of an inch on each end is not going to be a huge difference. So I'm going to use 118 feet for the total length of the antenna. The next formula, it calculates the length of the coaxial cable section in the center. And formula 325 divided by 3.9, 83.33 repeating, comes out to 83 feet 4 inches. Now, to this piece of coaxial cable up here on the end, I need to add some extra cable length there so that I can strip some insulation off and solder the two ends, or the center and the braided shield together. So I need to make this just a little bit longer. I don't really need but just an inch or two, but just to be on the safe side, I'm going to make that about 4 inches longer here and 4 inches longer on the other side. Just in case I mess up one side, I still have at least 4 inches to play with on the other side. So to this 83 feet 4 inches, I'm going to add 8 inches. That's 4 inches on each side, and I'm going to cut a piece of coaxial cable 84 feet long. And then to find the center of the antenna, the center of the coaxial cable length, you'll just take that measurement, which I call B here, to get this length C, which is, just divide it in half, and it's 41 feet 8 inches long. So on the coaxial cable, I'll probably start an inch back this way and an inch back that way, and probably make that cut probably 2 inches wide. Finally, the tail sections. Now that we have all of the other things calculated out, we can take the total length of the antenna and subtract the total length of the coaxial cable, and then divide that number by 2. And the tail sections come out to 17 feet 4 inches. Now, again, to that 17 feet 4 inches, I need to add some extra wire to tie off the antenna to my insulators. And I also need extra wire on the other ends of the antenna here, a little bit extra wire there to make that connection with to the other section of the antenna. To that 17 feet 4 inches, I'm going to add 2 inches on each end for connecting it to the coaxial cable, and then I'm going to add another 18 inches, a foot and a half more, just for to make it longer and shorter so I can play with the length and adjust it and see how that looks on the meter. So for my tail sections, I'm going to cut two pieces of 14 gauge wire that are 19 feet long. And so the antenna lengths again, got them drawn out here, 118 feet for the total overall length of the antenna, or 35.966 meters long. The center section of coaxial cable from here to here, 83 feet 4 inches, or 25.4 meters. From where the coaxial cable is soldered to the center here on the end, that section to the center is 41 feet 8 inches, or 12.7 meters. And the tail sections, 17 feet 4 inches, or approximately 5.283 meters for the ends of it. And again, you've got to leave some extra wire for making connections and also for tying it off on the ends of the antenna.